A local group is literally putting violence on the map. Pathways to Peace has launched a new computer mapping system. It pinpoints violence and hotspots all around the area and nearby resources to also help stop it. 13 WAM's Edward Moody tells us about it.
It's a disturbing trend in Rochester, an argument escalating to fatal violence.
The idea behind this system is to eliminate homicides.
About a month ago, Pathways to Peace took its fight against violence high tech. This computer mapping system, developed by RIT grad student Peter Tran, pinpoints reported acts of violence. This particular map shows hotspots near city high schools. There's a major one near Monroe High.
If you look at the hotspots surrounding the schools, it'll probably go right along a time frame of release from school up until 5:30, 5 o'clock.
Schools aren't the only hotspots on the Pathway to Peace map. They're also tracking places where young people congregate, like here at the Liberty Pole.
The community is very helpful in a way of giving us the necessary information to intervene before something escalates.
Pathways to Peace does that by connecting a report of violence with nearby help, whether it be police or a community organization, often within the first 24 hours or sooner.
Not only Rochester, but other cities across the country would be able to use this type of technology to eliminate the escalation of dispute to aggravated assault or homicide.
In Rochester, Edward Moody, 13 WAM News.
And that map system is funded by a $50,000 grant from the federal government.